correction, the May June correction, didn't do what it was supposed to do. What it's supposed to do is clear out all the speculators, rebuild the wall of worry, and get ready for the next leg of a rally. That's not happening this time, though. Mark Hulbert from MarketWatch will tell us what's going on. Mr. Hulbert, how are you?
Okay, how are you?
I'm doing all right. Getting through, just trying to get through the day. Tomorrow's the 4th. We'll relax, have a little time off. Explain to us what's going on here. It's very interesting that the bulls have not been cleared out, right?
Well, that's right. Here we are. The Dow Jones Industrial Average is, what, 400 points below where it hit its bull market high on May 1st. And so other things being equal, you'd expect the advisors not to be as bullish as they were then. After all, you see this pattern of bullishness tending to rise and fall with the market itself. And that's, of course, what happens in a recession. A bear market, or correction, which is where the bullishness will tend to be cleared off the decks, and then you get this wall of worry for the market to climb. This is not what's happened, as you mentioned in your intro there, over the last couple of months. We're seeing in our measurements, believe it or not, more bullishness now than we did at the May 1 bull market high, which is to say that we really are, the rally at least, is on borrowed time, I think, from a sentiment point of view.
And Mark, why do you think that is? I mean, there were some very scary things that went on the last six, seven weeks. The signs are that the economy is slowing down. Why do you think the bulls aren't being cleared out?
Well, I mean, that's a very interesting question. And, you know, there are a million of idiosyncratic reasons for each one of the advisors. I think this is why it's so important for a contrarian to really measure sentiment objectively. It's, of course, anecdotally, it seems like there's a lot more bearishness out there than there was 2 months ago. And you point out some of them. There's lots of awful news out there. The fact of the matter, though, is if you look at the stock market timers that we track at the Hulbert Financial Digest, there are quite a few of them. We look at the shortest term market timers, about 5 or 6 dozen of them. And there's a fact of the matter here. What percentage exposure to the market are they recommending to their clients? And if you look at the average of those exposure levels, it's higher now than it was in May 1. Regardless of what we may think is the case, the facts speak for themselves.
And you can see the Dow's up 40 points today. 6 months, it's, whatever, it's doing all right there. Do you think that this is a sign that the sell-off isn't over, that the correction isn't over, because you certainly haven't had this sort of, you know, the capitulation day?
Well, yeah, a couple of things. I would agree with that assessment. By the way, contrarian analysis, at least of the form that I'm exercising here, is a relatively, in fact, very short-term tool. It's only talking about the next several weeks to perhaps a month or two. So it isn't to say that the bull market is over, but it does suggest that the rally is not going to take the market into significant new all-time high territory, even if it makes it back to the May 1 highs. From a contrarian point of view, it would be far healthier for the market to pull back again. All those scary headlines that you mentioned start scaring people really, truly, thoroughly, and all the way through to their, you know, to their gut. And they say, this is it. I'm not going to get back in the market. Then you might have the sentiment foundation that would allow the market to go into significantly above the May 1 high.
All right. We have to leave it there, Mark Hulbert.